Lights are about to go out here. Moreira on pole, and we are underway here in the British Grand Prix 2022. Really good start by the poleman, Diogo Moreira. Really good launch away from the line as well by Ethan Guevara on that gas machine. But Moreira has the whole shot as they sweep through Copse for the first time.
Trying to keep an eye on Sergio Garcia. He's safely through turn one. Didn't appear to make too much early progress, but he's up behind the two Leopard Hondas. Oh. Very, very close between the two empty helmets, MSI teammates. It looks like Moreira has fought his way back ahead of Yamanaka.
Yeah, he was getting a bit roughed up there on the sweep through Magnus and Beckett for the first time. Guevara got him going into turn number two. So Moreira briefly was back in third, but he really toughed it out. Elbow to elbow with his teammate Yamanaka, fighting back through into second place through Magnus and Beckett.
Garcia is up one. He is up into 10th position. Look out for him pulling out from the slipstream. He's just in behind Ayumu Sasaki as the two empty helmets MSI riders, they both power past Ethan Guevara, who led onto the hanger straight. He's third coming out of it. Look how close this is. That's a brave, brave move from Ethan Guevara up the inside into farm. And it's really, really held up Yamanaka. He loses a couple of places.
Oh, round the outside by Dennis Onju. Brave in the extreme on Moreira going into village corner. A sensational first that has been so far for Onju. He's come from six. We know he's an aggressive hard charger. And he leads the British Grand Prix on lap one here. Onju now going through the entry corner. He's cracking the whip, isn't he? Like we're in a Grand National. Onju leads.
No real progress early on from the home favourite, John McPhee. He's up 1-9th with Garcia, the world championship leader, hot on his heels.
Poor first lap for Stefano Nepa. He started in fifth place, in the second row. He's outside the top 10 at the moment. Over the line, they come into complete lap one here at Silverstone. And with some slipstream out of Woodcote, great drive through that six gear last corner on a Moto 3 bike. Guevara powers back into leading the brakes by Onju into Copse Corner.
So big movers on the first lap, as you can see. Sasaki and Munoz.
Oh, Sasaki.
Speaking of being a big mover, through into second place, taking two in one go as he went into Maggots. Munoz, as you can see, left-hand side of your screen, the indicator next to his name. He's up into 12th place. He has now been notified that he must come through the long lap penalty lane, as has Adrian Fernandez. They have three laps to serve it.
Here comes Foggia. Guevara leaves him so much room. It's a wide circuit, Silverstone, multiple lines, but Foggia had to go through because it was like as wide as the M25, wasn't it, for him there to go through on Guevara.
Well, Guevara has been taking some defensive lines, particularly down the hanger straight. He's hugging the inside of the racetrack. He's practically riding on the white line on the rider's right down the hanger straight. And of course, they're heading towards a right-hander. He's now trying to get back past Foggia immediately, who of course took advantage of that gap into Village. So Guevara regains the lead. Now, he also takes a bit of a defensive line into Copse. He sort of holds the middle of the road as they approach the corner.
Onju just moves John McPhee out of the way, as you knew he would do. He's not scared of swapping paint, is he, and rubbing elbows and knees is the Turk. That gap though, Guevara going through Village Corner. Foggia went through. You couldn't have fitted one Moto 3 bike through. You could have fitted 50. That was how big the gap was. Foggia strikes back again into Copse Corner. He leads in at the start of lap number six. It's super tight. What a battle this is here in the British Grand Prix. On board, spectacular time to ride on board with Sasaki and John McPhee using, what, a four or five bike slipstream down the hanger straight, sweeps briefly into the lead. Again, he gets run out to the paintwork by Onju on the 53 bike, who will lead now down into Vale. It all concertinas up. Hold your breath, ladies and gentlemen, as they go through the tight turn 8 and 9, halfway around this lap number 7. You cannot take your eyes off this British Grand Prix Moto 3. It's already proving to be the barnstormer we hoped it would be. And it's advantage Onju through Abbey on lap 7.
And in amongst all this mayhem, there is a world championship lead on the line here. As you can see, bottom right of your screen, as it stands, Guevara leads it. Foggia with the bravery this time as Dennis Onju gets swamped into Maggots. He had McPhee on his right, Foggia on his left, and now they're both up ahead of him. Yeah, and he's been dragged towards the leading group by Onju, who really has lit this race up again, and he now leads it again. So for the first time in a number of laps, Dennis Foggia loses the lead. You can see this group closing up together once again. Garcia still hanging at the back of it. Is he on his limit just to be in this group, or is he trying to hold his powder dry and keep it for a latter stage in this race. Munyov, once again, certainly not backwards in coming forwards. He's up the inside into Vale. He's now back into the top five despite his long lap penalty, don't forget.
All total, got a couple of uppercuts there from Munoz and Massia. They both swept through on that sweep down through Vale. And Munoz now is starting to ghost his way back into, well, firmly back into podium contention. He's there on that 44 bike. He's now going to hunt down Sasaki on the brakes into Village. And Suzuki goes around the outside of Munoz into Village. Can he get that job done? He'll have the inside line now coming into the loop. It looks like he has taken it. Brilliant stuff by Suzuki. Look at the drive that Foggia got on Onju coming out of Cop's Corner. That's why he was able to sweep straight by the Turk going through Magnus and Beckett. In fact, Onju must have made a mistake, didn't he, coming out, accelerating out of that first corner, because he's gone from the lead now back down into third or fourth place, it looks like. Yeah, fourth.
Yeah, Massia took full advantage. He picked his pocket into Maggot. So onto the hanger straight now. There's the info for Foggia. I'd just leave him to it if I was honest, although they're telling him that the opponent is the number 53. There are about 11 of them, to be honest, right behind Dennis Foggia, who holds the lead. And once again, his teammate Suzuki, he's doing his level best to try and get the tow ropes out and latch himself onto the back of his fellow Leopard Honda, the number 7. Suzuki back into second, trying to hold Massia and onto a bit. And watch out for Munoz once again.
There's Munoz up the inside of Suzuki into Loughfield. Not a lot of room there, but as always, Munoz found a way through. Either needle stop from the Spanish teenager. So then we chalk off another lap here at Silverstone. 14 down, 3 to go. And Ivan Ortola hits the front for the first time in his world championship career, just days after his 18th birthday. This would be some belated present, wouldn't it be, for the 18-year-old on the Angelus MTA Team KTM. It's Ortola that leads the British Grand Prix. Sergio Garcia, when push comes to shove, he's really starting to show his form.
Oh, Foggia,
Sergio
too.
Garcia, Dennis Foggia then makes the big, big mistake going into the Village corner. The world championship
lead. Sasaki.
Ayuma Sasaki then. Well, he was involved in a controversial incident with Andrea Mina at round two in Mandalika, and the world championship has been turned on its head here in controversial circumstances here at Silverstone. Sergio Garcia, who just looked like he was working his way to the front of this Grand Prix, looking to extend his three-point lead over teammate Guevara in the championship, and he gets skittled by Sasaki going into the Village corner. Frustration and dejection then for Sergio Garcia, because if Guevara takes the checkered flag, he will be our new Moto3 World Championship leader going to Red Bull Ring in Austria in 2 weeks' time.
Onju, Ortola and Munoz. Look at Foggia back through, and Massia takes the pair of them.
Jaume Massia started this Grand Prix from outside the top 20. There's almost a dozen riders, maybe more, that have got genuine aspirations of a podium here in this Silverstone sizzler. What a race it has been in Moto3 to get the British Grand Prix underway. The fans have been loving it. I've been keeping an eye on the crowd through Woodcut. They've been on their feet. What action to kick off this round 12 here. Who will it be then? Down on the brakes in the Stowe corner. Foggia. Onju was almost grass cutting there, wasn't he? Going down the hangar.
Oh!
Ortola's gone down.
Guevara.
Oh, and Guevara's gone down. What an unbelievable two or three laps, a disastrous 3 minutes for the Gas Aspar team. Back at the front, Jaume Massia leads. You cannot take your eyes off this dramatic, unpredictable British Grand Prix. The two top men in the World Championship have been taken down in separate incidents. No Garcia at the checkered flag, no Guevara at the checkered flag, but who's going to take the checkered flag first here?
Could be anybody. Munoz is now back into the podium positions. He's just picked the pocket of John McPhee. There is Ivan Guevara, who thought he was taking the World Championship lead. He's now joining his teammate on the sidelines. Foggia, though, assuming the defensive line, if he can lead through Loughfield, he should lead across the line.
Some aggressive swerving there by Dennis Foggia then. On the brakes into Brooklands, he has the advantage. Massia leans on Munoz through the penultimate couple of corners, and it looks like it will be Dennis Foggia.
Munoz
British
down.
Grand Prix. Munoz, the latest high-profile casualty late on here. Through Woodcote, they come for the final corner. This is Dennis Foggia's British Grand Prix. He wins a classic Battle of Britain in Moto3. What a race. What a return to action after the summer break.
And Alex Lacey, the Silverstone Operations Director, gives Dennis Foggia a much-treasured trophy at the British Grand Prix. Foggia victorious as the Rocket fights himself back into title contention.